Savior, we continue to be in your presence this afternoon. We want to thank you for the fire that you have taken us, O Lord. And Father, Lord, during creation, you instituted a family. And you blessed it all, our Master and our Lord. And Father, Lord, we want to thank you for the families that are present here this afternoon. And we want to pray in Jesus' holy name that you may open our inner hearts so that we may listen from you, our Lord and our Savior. And before us, O Jehovah, we have your servant, Pastor Wisdom. And we want to pray in Jesus' holy name that this afternoon that you may use him as a vessel of honor to convey the message that you have for us this afternoon. We pray in Jesus' holy name that his mind may be tuned with heaven so that he may tap everything that, Lord, you want us to hear this afternoon and bring it to us. We prepare ourselves, Jehovah, to listen from you. Feed us with the word that is going to suit us for this day. Continue to be our Lord and our Savior. Continue to encourage us, O Lord, even as we continue to serve you in different families that you have given unto us. We bless you and we honor your holy name. For this, our prayer of faith, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's hold our hands as we welcome Pastor Wisdom to come and speak to us.
Yeah, I'm well in the Lord. I bless the Lord for this opportunity to come and just be with us today. I'm so grateful, Patron, for allowing me to come and be with these wonderful families. Our God is the God of families. Praise the Lord. And that is why we talk about the Trinity. The Bible talks about the Trinity being God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Sawa sawa. And that's the family unit in God. The family unit in God is God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. If you do a very keen study on that aspect, you see that God the Father is the father of that family. Praise the Lord. Then we have God the Son is the child, is the son of that family. Then we have God the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit comes to us as a helper. Praise the Lord. And who is the helper in a family? The wife. I'm so grateful, and I just want to appreciate the women leadership of this church and what God is helping you to do, because organizing such a forum is such an important thing, because it is only here that you are able to address some of the things that cannot be addressed outside there. Sindio. It is only here that you can ask questions and you don't feel embarrassed. Let me tell you something. There are some things about marriage you speak and you don't want to speak it when they are single people. Are you together? As you know, everyone who is married was once a single person. Sindio kweli. Na kuna mambo ugejua. There are some things, if you could have known when you are still single, they could have misinformed your decisions or informed your decisions. So when we come at such a forum, you are able to express yourself. You are able to ask questions. You are able to engage. And talking about our theme is talking the book of Psalms 139, talking about we are fearfully and wonderfully made. When we talk about being fearfully and wonderfully made, the Bible talks about how your bones were crafted, were brought together. And this mystery, as maybe we might have so much about interpreting that as the physical appearance, it has nothing much to do with the physical appearance. Praise the Lord. It is about the inner mechanism of the creation of God. The inner mechanism. Actually, you even see the Bible talks about you connected my inner parts. Praise the Lord. And being in marriage, because I'm talking about marriage today, I want to speak to this woman who is married. And I want to bring you some few aspects of a married woman and the kind of a lifestyle and the things that a married woman go through, just maybe according to God's expectation in her position in marriage. Praise the Lord.
And I want to bring you one aspect about a woman that is very known in the Bible called the Proverbs, that one woman. When I was going through this woman, there were some few things that I was able to see, and we'll be discussing some of them. One of the most key areas that I really identified with this woman is that Proverbs, that one woman is a giver, is not a receiver. There is nowhere you'll study Proverbs, that one woman, and you see her receiving anything. But every time you study that woman, she is giving. Did you know the husband to this woman is an elder of the city? And the elders of the city were not working. The work of the elders of the city, their work was to wake up, rise up in the morning and go to the city. At the entrance of the city, that is where their seats were set, just so that people can bring their issues and they could be able to maybe adjudicate over the issues of the city. So the man of this woman was not working. So it is this woman that you find waking up early, as the Bible says, going out to go and look for food to come and feed the family. That is the woman. She is a giver, not a receiver. When you continue to study and we'll begin to see some of these deep issues, you'll see even the Bible talking about her children call her blessed. Hello? This woman. Another aspect that you see about this woman is that even the husband places her even in the council of the elders. The husband does not complain about her. She places her. This man is also respected in the city because of this woman. Are you together? God has put a great responsibility in a woman. And I wish, by the grace of God, I wish my wife was able to come here. Yesterday, we were chatting with my wife. I was in the office, she was at home, and we began to chat. And there's one thing that my wife told me that made me actually thank God when I was still in my office desk. She told me, "I am proud that I am your wife. I appreciate the way you have mentored me." Praise the Lord. Because when we were marrying, there was where, okay, personally, I'm a trainer. I'm a professional trainer. I do trainings in banks, corporate organizations, and even in churches like now today. And what I say, that some of the things, my wife was not a trainer. And when God brought her into my life and we married, I realized that you can only give what you have. So I told her, I'll begin to train you. The trainings that I offer to other corporate women out there, I'll offer it to you. And you become one of the greatest corporate leaders in this country. And by the grace of God, I took my wife three good and classical topics and trainings. The first thing I took her through is monetizing your passion. I took her through a program of monetizing your passion. How do you identify your purpose in God and your giftings in God, and how can you make money out of it? And she was able to graduate. The second program I took her through is a program I call the Art of Public Speaking. If I can offer these services to the corporate, why can't I invest it to my wife? Hello? So I took her, it is a 2-month program. I took her through the program of the Art of Public Speaking. Today when she stands, before she could not even stand before people. And you know I'm a public person. So many times you go to a place and she'll be told, "Salimiana." Na mimi, si getaka asimame afanya aibu. You get my point. You know many men, hawataka give their wives watoke, akitoke actually sasa atasema. You know, you are waiting for a unagojea kuwa embarrassed. Are you together? Yani hata hutaki. Unaona hata kuna wengine anapewa microphone na anaambiwa salimiana tu. Kwa sababu anajua akianza kuongea ile mambo atasema ile anafaa kusema na ile hafai. So I realized that I needed to train her the art of public speaking. When you stand, what do you say? Are you together? And she graduated. The other class that she is now in the process of graduating is called personal branding. Say personal branding. Because in life you are either a brand, you are dika, you are boga point. Nimesema, in life you are either a brand or you are a commodity, depending on the way you present yourself. I wanted her to become a brand. People can be blessed. You know, when she goes to a place, people are not left complaining. People are left, you know, wanting more. Praise the Lord. So we began to walk through that journey. So when she wrote to me the messages yesterday, I never thought I had done so much, but I was really able to go back and see that it's true. It's true, there's something that I have added value into her life. And that is the challenge with many people. You know, she cannot be a threat to me, because I was joking with her the other day. I was telling her, you have the potential of being better than me, because some of the things I'm training you, I was never trained. You have somebody who can help you. Are you together? But by the grace of God, I really appreciate God for this one thing about her. She has a teachable spirit. You know, you may want to teach somebody, but they are not teachable. She has a teachable spirit. And that's what we say. That is something that every woman should embrace. If you are too big to be taught, then you are too small to teach. You are dika, you are boga point. I'm saying that if you are too big to be taught, then you are too small to teach. Ruse, God bless you. Najua nakuonea tu huko. Sija kusalimia. So, if you are too big to be taught, let me tell you, you must cultivate a teachable spirit. And never feel embarrassed when you are being taught. Are you together? See, I know some women here. How many people can cook nice chapatis? You can cook nice chapatis. And that is, hiyo ndio inaletaga shida na many men. Many men love chapatis. Ni kweli. Now, most of the women don't know how to cook chapatis. Women, listen to me. There's a difference between chapatis and burnt offerings. Are you together? There's a difference between what? Chapatis and? Yes, don't cook burnt offerings and you expect, you know. Mutu anakula chapo, hii siku ingine anasikia. Nini ninasikia uchungu huku? Hakupuki ni chapo aliku. Hakupuki alikula burnt offerings. So having a teachable spirit is, you can even find a sister in church who cooks very nice chapatis. You can go and sit down and be taught. Unamwambia, mimi nataka ukuje kwangu, nimenunua unga tano. Hizi unga tano nataka unifunze kupika chapo. Having a teachable spirit will make you a good woman, a good wife. Are you together? That is called obita dicta. Those of you who have done law, there's something you call obita dicta. Obita dicta are statements, by the way. When a judge is making some judgments, they are statements that he make by. They are not part of the judgment, but they are by the way. They are called obita. Sema obita dicta. Wacha ni watoe umeru. Sema obita dicta. Iyo sasa unaenda kutisha nayo watu huko kwa estate. Unaambia watu, ile unasemaga ni by the way, unambabia, iyo ni obita dicta. Iyo achana nayo. So, there are some 5 or 6 things that I want us to look at that you help us. Actually, I'm calling my, God gave me a vision, and I'm doing a book on designer woman, and that is part of what one of the programs my wife runs. In personal branding, I helped her to come up with some programs, and one of the programs is the designer woman program. She has written a booklet, and we are writing it together. So I have bought some of the things that I will share with you today, so that at least when the book is out, you'll also buy. Sindio? Yeah, utanunua. Sini kweli? Utanunua na designer woman. Designer woman. So I want to give you some aspects of the designer woman. Designer woman is the woman that God created. The woman that, not the woman that we see. The woman that God created. You know, there is a difference between what was created and what we see. Sawa sawa? Yes. So this designer woman is a relational woman. That is number one. Designer woman is a relational woman. Is a woman who can relate is a woman who can relate, who is relational. A woman who is relational. Now, you relate through communication, because every relationship is fed through communication. So women were not born to be silent. Women were born to speak. Are you together? And that is why when the Bible talking about I'll pour upon the book of Joel, I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh, the Bible talks about your old men shall have dreams. Are you together? Then it continues to say, young men shall see visions. Your daughters shall do what? Say, shall prophesy. You know, so prophetic ministry is not a silent ministry. Do you know you can just be a dreamer and you just keep quiet? You can be a dreamer and you're just there. You can be a visionary and you're just there. But a prophet must speak. And that is the ministry that have been given to women. The prophetic ministry. So is that the ministry of women is the ministry of communication. I wish I become the president of this country. Actually, the ministry for communication is a Patia Mama. Do you know there are many women journalists than men? You know that? There are more women journalists than men. Because women are good communicators. Are you together? Women are good communicators. Now, because women are meant to communicate, and that is why they were given the prophetic ministry, every woman must be speaking to somebody. And in your marriage, in the context of marriage, you must be in communication with your husband. A woman is always talking. So if the woman is not talking to the husband, she is talking to somebody else. Are you together? Let me show you. This is not Joey's John chapter 3. Genesis 3. Genesis 3, 1 to 6. I want to read the scripture here. Genesis 3, 1 to 6. The Bible says, the serpent was the shrewdest of all the wild animals. The Lord God had made one. The serpent was the shrewdest of all the wild animals the Lord God had made. One day he asked the woman, did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of the trees in the garden? Number two, of course we may eat from the trees in the garden. The woman replied, verses 3. It is only the fruit from the tree in the middle of the garden that we are not allowed to eat. God said, you must not eat it or even touch it. If you do, you will die. You won't die, the serpent replied to the woman. Verses 5. God knows that your eyes will open as soon and you will be like God, knowing both good and evil. The woman was convinced. She saw the tree was beautiful and its fruit looked delicious. She wanted the wisdom it would give her. So she took some of the fruit and ate it. Then she gave some to her husband who was with her, and she ate it too. Now, there's something that I want you to note here. This is a conversation between the serpent and the woman. Are we together? Now, the serpent was the shrewdest of all the wild animals the Lord God had made. One day, he asked the woman. The serpent asked the woman. And do you know, by the way, there's a lot of misconception. When people say that Adam was not there when Eve was taking the fruit, Adam was there. Have we read that? And she gave Adam, who was higher. Did you know he was there? You just see this. Verses 5, Mwisho. Then she gave some to her husband, who was with her. Si kumperekea alimperekea, alikuwa hapo. And he ate it too. That means that these guys were together, but they were not communicating. Have you ever found yourself in such a familiar place? are in the same bed, but you are not talking. Hello? Both of you are in the sitting room, no communication. Kila mtu ako kwa simu ya? Eh. That is the situation. Your situation haijaanza na wewe. It started in the Garden of Eden. The guys were together, but they are not communicating to each other. And if you are not communicating to your husband for this case, if your husband is not talking to you, can I surprise you? He is talking to another person. If you are not talking to your husband, you must be talking to another person. And that other person, can I surprise you, is a serpent. Anywhere you run, when you are not communicating with your husband, you are running to a dangerous creature. That place where you get some comfort, the place where you get some comfort and some solace when you are not in good terms with him, that is a serpent. And if it is not tamed early enough, the serpent in the book of Genesis is this dragon in the book of Revelation. Have you studied the book of Revelation chapter 12? The dragon is a serpent. So it have graduated. It has been graduating all these years. So relationships are fed through communication. You realize that constant communication with the others, with another serpent, builds a bond of love. And you begin to feel attracted to another person. And every time you begin to feel loved by another, your love goes to another person, there's always a disconnection from Adam. That is why Adam have not been able to convince the wife on anything, but the serpent can convince the woman. This man, who is a serpent now, can now even convince you to even tell your husband, on this day I'll not be there. We are going for a conference in my workplace. Then you go to Mombasa with a serpent. Because the serpent have convinced you. This serpent is very shrewd. The serpent has the ability to convince you that that man is very stupid. How can he treat you like that? Anaezaje akakunyima pesa ya salon? Kwani hafikiriagi? It's very easy for the serpent to convince you. Anytime you lose communication with your Adam, the serpent is always very close. Let me tell you, women, when there's no communication, when that relationship is gone, that is when what we call the power of X. The power of X. That is when the power of X is revived. Before every woman was married here, there is somebody else you are seeing. True, of course. Before any woman was married here, you were seeing another man. Actually, some of you had suffered from what you call the Samaritan woman syndrome. You had had five, and even the one that you are having that time was not your husband. Right together. Samaritan woman syndrome. You had had five. Some of you, before you got married, you had had five. Hello? And even the one that you thought was the one was not the one. Finally, you landed somewhere and you are thanking God you are there. And some of you are still feeling that he's not the one. Let me tell you. So what is happening is that that power, that person you connected to emotionally cannot be ignored. The fact that you got married does not mean that they are dead. And every time you are not in good communication, that is when this person likes your message. After 10 years, the serpent, you cannot joke with this spirit. After 10 years, hata uko na watoto wakubwa, divi unaona kimutu kimeandika kwa Facebook. Hi. And let me tell you, the high now continue graduating. Graduating. And you find good because you didn't hate that person. You only disconnected. Hey, together. There is something that had connected you with that person. You know, there are some things you can never ignore. Do you know why they are called X? X means examples. They were examples of what you wanted. So your ex-boyfriends were examples. X means examples. So they had something admirable. There's something that you had admired in them. So when it is not, and most likely, you realize that these people, their strength is the weakness of your husband. Are we together? This guy could take you out. This guy could treat you. Sasa hiki kenye kilikuoa hakiendagi nje. Haendi. Are you together? Hae? Haendi. Hana shughuli hata badhi la kubukangi. Yule alikuwa anakubuka my friend. Paka anakuorganizea na hamjaua anaorganize surprise. Huyu hana maneno. Kazi yake tu anaigiaga kwa nyumba tu. Anakaaga JB. No JB, JB inamaanisha jababo eku. Anaigiaga. Let me tell you. But there is also something that attracted you to him. There is another thing that attracted you to him, because even if he don't have all those extras, sema extras, he has the main thing. He have a character of a husband. Are you together? He have the character of the husband. He loves his children. He is able to provide. Are you together? Yule mwingine, anakupereka uko kuote, anakupereka uko kuote. Lakini responsibility hataki. Ukimwambia kuna mahali nilikuwa nataka 1000, ebu nitakupigia. So the weakness of this one is the strength of the other. So when you are not in good communication, it is very easy to see the strength of the other serpent. And the serpent comes. And you see at that point, you need what the serpent is able to provide. Are you together? So you need to be very careful, because this spirit of X has come so powerfully in our days that you find people who are married, they are still in communication with their ex. Actually, hata yeye unapata alioa na wewe uliolewa. Lakini you must go out for coffee. Hello? Ukikwama kabla hata uambie bwana yako, yeye ndiye anakukwamua. Hebu nitumie dhahiri. Unajua haezi akakufail. Hello? Na wewe you usually comfort yourself, unasema, sisi, hakuna gamabo, it's not beyond. But let me tell you, it will graduate. And can I surprise you women? There is no any other great way that makes a woman feel like they have appreciated somebody than giving them herself. Hello? The greatest gift you can give to somebody as a woman is yourself. That is why, unaonanga, mutu akikusaidia sana, akusaidie. Unaonanga hakuna pesa naweza patia huyu mutu. Hakuna nini unamwambianga nimejireta. Kama dhabihu iliyo hai. You offer yourself as a living sacrifice. Let me tell you. And that is how many marriages are coming down. You went thanking him, but there's nothing else that you could have given them but yourself. Be very careful on what you call the spirit of X, the power of X. Be very careful on what you communicate. As a woman, take responsibility. If you are not in good communication with your husband, always be there. Pay the price. Be the person to initiate conversations. Are you together? Yes. And that is why we said, humility. You know, sometimes ata kama alikukosea, why can't you just write mumekasirishana kwa nyumba na yeye anaenda kazi. Ameacha umejam, umekasirika. Let me tell you, hapo ndipo huwa unajijaza. And I will show you how you do it. Unajijaza, unajua ata. Let me tell you, because I'm a man. Ata wakati hamusikizani, every time somebody leaves for work, na hamjasikizana, anaedaga kama amesubuka sana, hata kama anajijaza. Wacha nikwambie, usiwahi ruhusu your man aende nje kama hamsikizani na kama umemkasiria. Afadhali umwandikie. He can even cause an accident. It happens. It happened to me. Unaenda tu ukifikiria. Yaani umetoka hapo kama stadium, but inward you are very weak. You are wounded. Inside you, you can't even concentrate in your place of work. But because of the ego, he wants to show you that he has carried the day. And maybe it's a very stupid argument. Are you together? The issue is, nani atachukua watoto kutoka shule? Because the house help alienda. Mimi niko na mkutano jioni. Si mimi nilikuwa anakuambia niko na crisis. Nini? Like that. Anaacha amesema, nimesema hao watoto uende na ametoka. Sasa mume, wewe ujue vile utajipa. And you know, for us men, there is a way we assume that you women have no plan. Nyinyi hamkuagi na mipango yenu. Munafaa kufit. Actually, for myself, naweza pata nimepanga mambo zangu na expect nikimwambia align kwa hiyo mipango yote. Sasa ananiambia, guys, nilikuwa nakwambia naenda Nakuru. Mimi hata nimesahau, nilipanga yangu nikasahau hata yako na mipango. But you know that is how men are created. Are you together? I'll be showing you how this woman is able to rise above every circumstance. Praise the Lord. How you can rise from every limitation of your life, from every obstacle, from every circumstance. So always be ready to pay the price. Be the one to initiate conversation. Even if he have left as a stalling, just write to him a message, tell him, as you go to work, may God bless you and may God be with you. That gives him peace. That's not an ordinary woman. And I didn't come here to talk about the ordinary woman. Because the ordinary woman will feel wounded and she will continue cursing the man. Are you together? The designer woman is the woman who is able to bless her husband even when he is leading. Are you together? And you know, I thank God you called a man to speak to you. Because I didn't want to come here and incite you. You know, women can be good in inciting each other. Eh? Actually, there should be a law prohibiting women to speaking to women. Because you people come here, excite, you know, incite each other by the time you are coming home. Ile maneno tunaonanga. So I came now to speak our version from the other end. So bless him. Because your mouth was meant to bless. Your mouth is prophetic. Did I say that? That you have a prophetic ministry. Prophetic ministry is calling gold out of the dust. Even in the dust, in the midst of dust, and I think I read to you this, that scripture sometimes back when I was here. The book of Job 28 from verses 5. The Bible says that out of the, on the surface of the earth you find food. But deep down the shafts of the earth you find gold. And I said that where you find gold is not on the surface. If you need food, just farm on the surface of the earth. Ukita, huwezi ukaenda kuchimba shimo ya maji, unasema unataka kupanda mahindi. Have you ever seen such? Mtu anaenda kupanda mahindi, alafu anachimba shimo kama ni ya choo. Ukimuuliza, ni ya nini baba so and so mnachimba? Ni ya mahindi. Kwani shida yako ni gani wewe mzee? Shimo ya mahindi ni hapa juu. Kwa sababu chakula utaipata hapa juu, kulimalima hapa juu. Lakini kama unataka dhahabu, lazima utoe uchafu yote, utoe mchanga yote, uende ufikie mawe, uendelee kuchimba utoe mawe. Naacha nikwambie, kuna wanaume wengine sisi sasa, unajua there are different types of soil. For example, types of soil. Unajua uzuri, wakati naambiagwa nikuje Methodist, huwa nafurahia because Methodist ni watu wamesoma. Actually, that is what people say out there. Methodist ni watu wamesoma. Wewe unajua Methodist imetoka huko Meru. So there is no way you can be in Methodist and not have a degree. Are you together? Hata kama ni ya upishi. A At least you have a degree somewhere. Hata kama ni ya umama, kama mimi. Hello? So, types of clay. Types of soil. Number one? Clay soil. Second? Loam. Sand. Cotton. Sasa wacha ni kuambia, wacha ni kushangaze. Some of these husbands, do you know nyinyi hamukutengenezwa na udongo? Did you know? You people are from the bone. Do you know that? But where did man come from? Sasa let me ask you. The fact that there are different kinds of clay informs, and you need to understand the kind of a soil your husband is made of. Kuna wengine cotton. Unaona ka cotton kale kana shikaga migu. Adwa nyitanu, adwa gutindirira, you know. Adwa mata weka undu. Gamu, gamu. Are you together? So, when you understand the kind of soil your husband is made of, you are able to deal with him. And you find another man, another woman's husband, is made of loam soil. Ama sad. Sad imeachana achana. Are you together? Haijashikana sana. Mwingine ni cotton. Mwingine ni clay. That is why all these men are different. But now as a prophetic woman, you are supposed now we say that prophetic ministry is getting gold out of the dust, out of the soil. You must be able to, your ability to remove the soil is work. Are you together? Work. It involves work. Removing the soil first. Sometimes removing even the clay, the cotton, the maram. Are you together? All those types of clay, you remove them. But what you are looking for is gold in that man. Because hidden deep within that man is gold. What you get out of him is determined by how deep you are willing to dig. How deep are you willing to dig? Otherwise, if you just work on the surface of that man, all that you get is food. He'll be bringing bread when he comes in the evening. No investment, nothing. Actually, some of you are paying school fees for your children. You are the surface of that man. Food. If you need gold, dig deep. Dig deeper. Are you together? Become the prophet in that house. Become the prophetic voice of that man. Continue to call greatness out of him. Praise the Lord. Yes. I remember, and I can give you this testimony for the glory of God. We have lived in Nakuru for a very long time. I used to work in pipeline, KPC, as a manager there. And we were doing very well. We were doing very well. Actually, when I was marrying my wife, I was very stable financially. I was doing very well. To some extent, by the grace of God, at the age of 26, I was driving my own car. And that is the time I married. Now, being a senior manager in an oil company, our firstborn hakuwa ijua kubebwa na matatu. But a time came, at a certain time in life, and I felt that my grace to work in pipeline is gone. And I felt so much disconnected from that job. I could go to speak to students in schools where I'm not even being paid anything. I'd close the office. People could call the head office because I have switched off my phone. People have loaded fuel. They cannot get a gate pass or whatever because I'm not in the office. And it got to a place I said, why am I denying another person get this job when my heart is disconnected from this place? I had not gotten a very good plan of, I hadn't found an exit strategy that was good for me. Because I want to speak to people. I want to go out there and add value to people's lives. But people are not paying. Actually, I remember I went to one of the schools in Nakuru. Mahali dani, nakubuka hata nilikopa. I could even borrow to go and speak to people. All that I was asking is an opportunity. So I started this in a secondary school, and I went there and I spoke like a dying prophet. My friend, I preached my tongue out. At the end of the service, I had borrowed some money. I think 200. I knew at least these people will appreciate me. I'll go and pay back the money. And at least go home with a bread. My friend, the patron came. The patron aliniambia, Mtu wa Mungu, kuna kitu ndani yako. Unaenda bali. Nikaona, haya, nikamwambia, thank you. Do you know alimalizana na mimi hivyo? Mungu akubariki na akuonekanie. Na nikaenda nikasema, na ni kweli ameniambia ukweli. Ninaenda bali. Kwa sababu, sina fare. I have no transport. Nimetumia pesa kwenda, the only money I had borrowed. And I had borrowed some little money because I knew maybe I could be appreciated. I would get some transport back. Nikakumbuka na huyu mtu ameniambia ninaenda bali na ni ukweli. Inaonekana sasa. And they escorted, some boys escorted me to the gates of the school. Let me tell you, I stood there. I stood there. Those times, hata mambo ya M-Pesa, mimi hata sikuwa na, I don't even think I could even think of M-Pesa, sijui hata kama ilikuwa imekuja. I stayed there for a very long time. Paka sasa nikaona, I'm embarrassing myself with the people, before the people. I had to begin to walk. I began to walk. And I walked a very long distance. Very long distance. Kira kiri nisaidia ni, my sister was married there. Mimi nilichoka, and you know, let me tell you, that is why ministers, most of the pastors and ministers of the gospel, are advised to marry. Did you know why? Because you are the lowest moment of a minister is after ministering the word. That is their lowest moment. You remember Jesus, people thronging around him, and he looked back and said, "Who have touched me?" Are you together? And the disciples are telling him, people are hanging around you. How do you ask? How do you even know who is touching you? And Jesus said, some virtue have left me. I feel I have no power. Some power have left me. That is how ministers feel after ministering. Some virtue leaves. And that's the lowest moment of a minister. So I was so weak. I told you I spoke like a dying prophet. Then I am walking. Now let me tell you. I have begun to speak to people. I have resigned. I cannot afford anything in the house. My friend, were it not that God had ordained this woman to be my wife, we could have separated. Some people even ganged up to even begin to convince my wife, actually asking her. You know there are people who are sent by the devil. Demonic agents who even came and asked her, did you really pray? Are you sure this is the right man who was up? Now, even if he was not the right person, what does she do now? Afanya nini na ashaolewa? Are you together? The people began to doubt that we are meant to be together. But glory be to God that by the grace of God, I have even spoken to my wife about my vision in life. And I had told her, I don't see myself in pipeline. I don't see myself in the oil industry. I see myself speaking to nations. I see myself, actually, I launched my manifesto with a lot of passion. And she bought the manifesto. Praise the Lord. She bought the manifesto. And regardless of what now you are going through, she stood by me. I could even hear her wake up very early in the morning to pray for me. Even when I'm leaving the house, my friend, unajijaza. At that time, I cannot even pray. Shayona, mahali unafika, unaenda. People know you, you had a car. You cannot even fuel the car. We parked our car in the parking. Gari ikaanza kubadilisha rangi. Vile imechomeka na jua. Actually, miguu yote ikaenda chini. Sasa nikaona tires zitaharibika, nikainua juu na mawe. You cannot even fuel that car. Leave alone. I had to get using it. So we went through a very, very, very difficult time. And it is in that season. And I'm talking about somebody who was swimming in big money. At that, actually, at even, I think, 27 years, 28, we even have our own petrol station. We owned a petrol station at the gas depot. My wife was running the businesses. Tulikuwa tumejipanga vizuri. Hata wakati na resign, tulikuwa tumejipanga. But sometimes things happen otherwise. Are you together? Pump zikaanza kuleta shida. Gas ilikuja ikabeba one night. Mitungi yote. And everything was not working out. And let me tell you, when that man is at that state, you can only be a prophet to that man. Maybe sometimes, even for women, I'm talking about relationships and being a prophetic voice to the life of a man. Maybe sometimes you even go, your man goes out there and maybe you had not even agreed. He goes and takes a loan because of his ambitions. He is saying that this is the business I want to do and I want to take a loan about this and this much because I need to do this business. And you feel like, no, you know the risk of taking a loan. But again, he is so ambitious, you cannot stop him. How many people know if a man wants to do something, he have to do it? Even if you approve or you don't approve. Then when he goes there out there and invests and he loses the money, the most dangerous thing a woman can ever do is to laugh at that woman, at that man. The most dangerous, that man can commit suicide. You laugh at him. Akikuja kwanza wewe unamwangalia. And you know there is a way. You know, we married people, there is a way. Unaonaga kakitu, ni kama tunagojea nanga mtu wa fail, especially kama hamuku agree. Wacha apoteze, apate kichwa. You know, let me tell you. And sometimes you are fighting with him and you want to prove that you are right, he was wrong. That is not the way to go in marriage. That's not the right way. Actually, let me give you a free advice. Anytime. And God knows your role in your family is to support, is to help. That is why God gave you that role. Helping. Are we together? And I keep saying, and you are not a helper because you are stupid. Some of you, if you are in school with your husbands, you could have beaten them in class. True of us. You begin here ni cotton. Yeah, Nico. But by the virtue of the order of God, he is the head. And in marriage, it's not about superiority.